So, there you go. Then he comes into a chapter on emotions, which is very, very fitting. People frequently, he says, Swamiji says, people frequently talk about knowing the mind and its various faculties, but they don't talk about feeling. How can one know something without feeling it? When one perceives something, the first thing he is aware of is sensation. If one is not feeling something, he cannot know it. And if he loses the power to feel, he becomes insensitive. Those who are insensitive, who are not very emotional, who have learned to intellectualize everything, cannot become creative. They do not realize that beneath the thinking process lies the real source of creativity, which is emotion. The right use of thinking is expression, but the right use of emotion is creativity. Emotion is very great power. It is the highest power in one's possession. When it comes to emotion, all human beings are one and the same because intelligence has no place before it. When one becomes emotional, he finds that his reason has left him and that he cannot help himself. When one is emotionally upset, he becomes blind, loses the power of discrimination, and his entire behavior, mind, action, and speech becomes abnormal. Misuse of emotion is destructive, but this does not mean that all emotional power in itself is destructive. Those who are very emotional can become very creative if their emotions are properly guided and if they learn to direct them in a constructive way. People who know how to use their emotions creatively become successful in the external world and remain happy at the same time. Remember, he said earlier, doesn't matter, you have a purpose in life, doesn't matter what you call it. And the first thing he mentioned was happiness. So here, it's not meaning to say become successful in the world, and as a result of that success in the world, now I'm happy. He's saying you can, the one people who know how to use their emotions creatively become successful in the external world, and they also remain happy, not because of the success in the world. Now I'm happy. I made my millions, and now I'm happy. Rather, I've done the stuff in the world, and I've sought this higher purpose. I'm happy. When emotion is led by devotion, it is called ecstasy. The greatest things in the world have been done by people at the height of ecstasy. Those who knew, look at the constant joy that came out of Swami Rama while he's building this place we're sitting in. Isn't it? I mean, the guy was always happy. You remember the story I told you? One day I was sitting in the ashram, and I was thinking about Swamiji all afternoon, just with this gratitude. And I wanted to do something for him to show him how much I appreciated him. I heard the car come down the driveway, and he came walking around the corner there, and I went and joined him and walked with him a little. I said, Swamiji, I want to do something for you. You know, to show my gratitude. I said, what can I do for you? You know what he said? Looked over the shoulder, kind of looked like this, smile came. He looked right in my soul, so to speak, and said, enjoy life. What he said, enjoy life. And somehow it struck me that he meant this, and he meant it at a very deep level. I didn't intellectually understand it, because I said back to him, feeling the depth that which he was saying that, I was feeling that. My response, there was no match back here. So my response was, I don't think I know how to do that. Enjoy life. At the depth, the intensity with which he meant it, which is what hit me. And you know what he said? It will come. And again, I think the reason he said that to me is because he knew he'd just hit me in the head again with that big stick. Bang. Here, got your attention. You haven't been listening. Here, bang, take that. What do I really want you to do for me? He was saying. That's why I said, what can I do for you? And his answer of what I could do for him is for me to enjoy life. I said, I didn't know how to do it. He said, it will come. I think he said it like that because he knew he just hit me on the head again. Got my attention once again. And he was right. Somewhere along the way after that, keeping doing this stuff, I learned how to do it. I think. And I kind of enjoy life.